sound like my usual self. But when I started going to WordCamps in the beginning of this year, it was pretty weird that I had never spoken an event before March. I kind of got into a habit of having a Swiss crew from me. It was by accident, like just the Swiss crew happened to be there at my first conference and then happened to be there at a couple of other conferences, so I'm super excited to be here and talk in front of all of you. Like now you are my Swiss crew and my other Swiss crew is also here. Thank you guys. I'm cutting. Alright, so today WordPress powers more than 24 hours on the web. And it is just growing rapidly in the last couple of years. And I want to talk to you today about one of the factors that helped it grow so much. My name is Petya. I do project management for HumanMade, which is a UK-based WordPress agency that does enterprise projects. I love my job, and as part of my job, campaign that this year I get to professionally contribute to WordPress too. I've been doing it for a while. I started as a translator and then I kind of picked up a translation editor role and then kind of picked up helping other translators. I also do a little bit of community work. I'm a WordCamp organizer, like most of the people involved in translations. And I have like a separate thing with a non-profit media foundation that tries to help independent media succeed in my home country of Bulgaria. Most of my time just contributing, though, is dedicated to the Polyglot team. And the Polyglot team is the team that translates WordPress. So today, I kind of want to talk about WordPress and languages a little bit, kind of to get on the same page for you to get to know how well WordPress is distributed across the world. And then I want to make a couple of terms clear, IATM and LTNN. That's important for plugin and theme and WordPress internationalization. And also, I will talk a little bit about how you, as a plugin or theme developer, can use the WordPress approach to grow your business. So first, WordPress and languages. WordPress is growing. It's grown by more than 10% in just 5 years. And in 2014, it reached a very important milestone. speaking of languages, the top languages of the world right now, there are more than 4,000 spoken still, even though some of them are spoken in very, very few places and by very few people. But the top languages in the world are Chinese, Spanish, English, Arabic. Hindi, Portuguese, Bengali, and Russian. Contrary to popular belief, English is really not the most well-distributed language in the world. It's just business language. So, according to the 15th edition of Epilogue, these are the most spoken languages. And most CMSs are built in English. It's business language, it's also a software language of sorts. Matt Mullenweg and Mike Little, the co-founders of WordPress, are both native English speakers. For CMS to grow globally, though, English kind of is not enough. So, how many languages does WordPress speak? A lot. That's the answer. A lot. WordPress speaks more than 100 languages, and it's learning new languages every day by its awesome community. It has 156 locales. Explain a little bit later what it is. And new locale is being requested almost every week. And from those 156, 67 are translated at 100%. That means that every string in WordPress administration and the default themes, everything that gets shipped with WordPress, is fully translated in 67 languages. There are a couple that are still developing, including two Swiss German locales and one locale in Romansh. How to pronounce it, right? Romansh? Okay. So So the top languages of WordPress are English, Japanese, German, Spanish, Chinese, Arabic, Portuguese, and French. Those are based on the downloads, like how many people use those language packs and those languages. And all those languages are supported by the Polyglot team, the community team that has translated them from the first train to the last. In WordPress 4.0 in 2014, international downloads surpassed English downloads for the first time. That means more people now own WordPress in other languages than English than they did in English. This is kind of the top trend there was. So English was downloaded about 6.5 million times. And then Japanese skipped a number of almost 3 million downloads. Uh-huh. And the reason for that is that the Japanese WordPress community is insane. They're super active. They're very, very aware. They translate every string the moment it gets in. And one of the other reasons for that is that there are some places in the world, like Japan, where if you're not fully localized, you cannot be used as a product. German is over there too. There are a couple of German locales, and the German team is actually translating German into two different versions. They have an official, formal German, and informal German that is more, you know, day-to-day. So, how does that happen? And what is the locale? So, from a geographic perspective, the locale is a place. But from a software perspective, it's an ID that's used to define a language and a place, the place that the language is spoken at. And also, it consists of a couple of other things, like the text direction of the language, and also dates, numbers, you know, all those things are different for different languages in different places. So, IATN and L10N are two terms that are very often used when it comes to translating software. IATN is the abbreviation of internationalization, and it means creating translatable software. It's a developer term. It means you have to code your software in a way that makes it easy for translators to then extract all the strings, everything that WordPress tells the users, both in the front and back end, and make it translatable and make it and translate it into another language. And localization, L10N, the abbreviations, you can understand why. It's like everyone's too lazy to write all those long words. So localization means translating, but not just. Localization also means applying all those cultural principles that are location dependent. Principles like choosing the right symbols, the right colors when you create a website, choosing the right date format, choosing the right number format, measurement systems. So that's all in the core of localization. WordPress and internationalization. To make WordPress translatable, I've put a couple of links here for plugins and developers. There is very good documentation on how this is done. I'm not going to focus on that today because I'm not a developer and there are better people to teach you about that. There is a plugin handbook, a theme handbook with set of sections for internationalization. And if you're a developer and you think you already have it figured out, you can go and test your internationalization skills. Global team engineer at Automatic, Alex Kurt, built an internationalization test for developers. It's super interesting. I took it, even though I'm not a developer. And I got 6 out of 10, which was still better than like a couple of developers that I know. But yeah, go test your skills. You might learn a lot of things too. Now, localization is something that I'm going to focus a little bit more on. Localization is not just translation, as I said. And once the software is made available for translating, it's up for the translators to kind of make it usable for a specific place, for a specific language, but also for the place that the language is used in. So, WordPress uses an open source translation management system called WordPress that powers all of the WordPress core translations. And how that system works is there are translation contributors that can be all of you. You have to go and create a WordPress blog profile, and the next thing you know, you can start translating into Swiss German or other languages, you know. And then there are translation editors, which are the people that are kind of responsible for keeping the consistency of the language, so that the language can only speak formally or informally, or that common terms are always used in the same way. For example, like email is always spelled the same way. There are 17 different ways to spell email. Does it have dash? Does it not have a dash? Especially in Cyrillic, when there is also the question, does it get transliterated or not? So, Translate WordPress .org is the web home of translations of WordPress, and Polyglots team lives at main.wordpress.org/polyglots, and at slash teams you can also see all of the teams that are contributing right now, usernames and everything. A little bit about the Polyglots community. I feel like just in this slide I can say passion more than mental diligence for presentation. So that's why I'm not going to say anything. I can restrict myself from saying it at all. The Polyglots community consists of locals. Those are people, like volunteers, that come from specific places. They request the languages as spoken in the places where they live. And what's interesting is that even though most locales are started by developers who just needed something translated into the language because a client needed it or something like that, a lot of non-developers later join in, and that's amazing for locales because developers have a very interesting style of translating software, a very literal one. To give you kind of an idea of what, because you don't know, you don't speak Bulgarian, to give you an idea of the mistakes I've seen in literal translations for Bulgarian, I'll point out a couple of failures big brands made when they tried to literally translate their slogans into different languages. So, let's just take a look at some of those. So in they're finger-licking good slogan to "We'll eat your fingers off" in Chinese, because they translated literally. Corinth, which is a brand of like a non-alcoholic drink, translated their "Turning Loose" slogan into, you know, "Suffer from diarrhea" in Spanish. And "Body by Fisher" and "Carbs by Fisher" don't even get me started. That's General Motors, a huge brand. Schweppes tonic water versus Schweppes toilet water in Italian. You know, you can imagine how much Italians enjoy that. So when I speak of developers translating software, like, most developers don't use software in languages other than English, right? So they have no idea why they're doing that, apart from just translating word by word everything that is there. And there are a lot of curious cases. So non-developers, users, actually make a lot of sense in the Polyglots team, and there are more and more people getting involved, just because, you know, we keep traveling the world and, like, urging people to come contribute to WordPress even though they're not developers. And most people, the easiest way to get them started is actually to join a translation team. Excuse me. So, literal translation aside, localization is, again, far more than just translating. It includes all of those things. A favorite example I like to give when talking about cultural-specific things that a lot of people take for granted is my good friend Jenny Wong, and a colleague of our death. So I went to her place in March for a couple of weeks, you know, traveling, did everything, stayed with her for a bit, and, like, I brought her flowers when I went, and because I love daisies, I brought her this huge, like, bouquet of white daisies. And she opened the door and she met me with, like, a frozen face. And she's very abrupt. If you know her, you know. Like, you know. And she said, "White means death in China." She's Chinese. I didn't even know that. Like, white was like the purest color for me, you know, freedom, whatever. White means death. White means death in China. So that's one color example that I can give that caused me, you know. So she never wears white. That she said. I wear it to a funeral, she said. And these are funeral flowers she brought me. Wasn't enough. Of me, of course. To be so culturally insensitive. Another example I like to give is like the symbol of victory for so many Western countries, that can get you a good beating in the UK. Yeah, like don't even go to Scotland. And you know, this in Spain, no, don't do it because, you know, it might mean tip top or like awesome around here, but there it means asshole. So just don't do it. Yeah. And, you know, the UK has all these weird measurement systems. Who measures themselves in stones? I'm sorry. Well, yeah, the British do, obviously. Anyway, so localization has to give light even to languages that seem figured out, like English, right? English is an official language for, you know, a lot of countries, like, it's an official language for the USA, for Canada, for Australia, for New Zealand, you know, for Ireland. So, WordPress native English, a native language is also English, right? It's English, so it should be figured out. Both of the co-founders, you know, we use that mother tongue. However, even though Mike Little is very British, WordPress doesn't just speak English. WordPress speaks white, cool, geeky dude from Texas English. That's the English WordPress speaks. So let's imagine this cool, white, geeky dude suddenly deciding to move to the UK to work with his name. Like, just imagine for a second. And because we do like big, like huge projects, like, what's the hugest project we can build in the UK? We can build, like, probably a website for the royal family, right? So, the cool geeky white dude from Texas goes to Buckingham Palace and starts with, "Howdy, Your Majesty." Howdy. Obviously not impressed. Okay, the Brits, you know, they can be a little, you know, snobbish. So let's go to Australia. Australians are fun, you know, right? So we're going to Australia, and like, we want to build a website for, say, actor Hugh Jackman, who's Australian. And we start with like, howdy. No, I don't want to make this guy angry, you know, there are things coming out of his hands, and so yeah, moving on, going to Canada. Now we just made Justin Bieber cry. New Zealand? New Zealand? Who's a cool guy we can build a website for in New Zealand? Howdy, Russell Crowe. I'm not even going to try going. I'm going to Ireland with the howdy thing. There are 44 plugins in the WordPress repository that are especially dealing with getting rid of howdy. 16 of those plugins only do that. Cool, geeky, white, this protects the single. So that, I don't know if Constantine is around. I hope he's not. Because Constantine is going to tell me. I've been to the discussions about how strings, you know, how the core team makes up what a string should be. So they're trying very, very hard to make it sound neutral. Now, even though there's a lot of legacy text in there, and like a lot of text lag and everything, they're trying very hard to make it sound neutral. However, even if you make it sound neutral, the Brits are not going to be happy because there's that U after the O in words like color that WordPress is missing, you know? And it uses that in words like localization instead of an S. What kind of is that, you know? So they're not going to be happy. WordPress needs to speak a language That's locale-specific, location-specific. And it does. WordPress has four different English locales. The Brits are not happy that theirs is not the original, obviously. But at least the Great Britain version of English says, how do you do, instead of how do you. And the Queen is happy, you know, and it says, how's it going, because, you know, Australians are so loose. And it has good day, no, sorry, that's in Canada. Good day is in Australia. You should hear my colleague Dave's daughter say it. So cute. Super awesome. And another colleague of ours, Tari, who is from New Zealand, started working on the New Zealand version of English and is greeting with Kia Ora, which is the local greeting of the Maori. So, what are we learning from all this? This is the data from the 2014 State of the Word for how people are using WordPress. You can see in the purple that people using it as a CMS, in green it's people using it as a blogging platform, and in 2013 in the survey appeared a question, are you using it as an application framework? And a lot more people, I'm sure that this year's number is going to be even bigger. So, WordPress is getting more professional. That's kind of the conclusion of all this. And WordPress getting more professional is going to need all the extensions to WordPress that make it so popular to also sound professional in any language. Which means that if I want to build an e-commerce shop, I don't only need WordPress to speak my language. I also need WooCommerce to speak my language if I'm going to use WooCommerce for my e-commerce shop. I'll need Jetpack to speak my language. I'll need all the plugins that I use to speak the language that WordPress already speaks in my language. So, one of the main tasks of the translation editors is to maintain consistency between translations. And that's why it's a hard job. And it's a job that often requires more than one person to take care of it. If you want to learn a little bit more, or maybe join any of the teams, you can do it at translatewordpress.org, at makewordpress.org/polyglots, that's where the polyglots team lives. Some of the people here are already a part of this, more or less. And there's a lot of work to be done because it means that translations can now be done on WordPress or make WordPress on translatewordpress.org for both WordPress core and all the translation, all the themes and plugins in the repository. This is a process that started a couple of years back. WordPress now can be installed in a different language from the beginning. Before, you had to go to a local site, download the language pack, install the language pack, and now there's a nifty drop-down menu that you can choose your language for from the install. And then, the next step for this are the theme and plugin directories in different languages, where you go to a local site, you go to the plugins tab, and you see plugins that are translated, already translated in your language. If you want to check out how many locales are there and how many plugins are translated into what, you can head to translate and you will see like a list of all the 156 locales. You can click on one and you can browse through different projects. Again, the plugin handbooks and the theme handbooks are here. That's for developers mostly. So, the last thing I want to talk about is how you can use WordPress's experience to kind of apply it to your business model. If you're developing products, you have to know your audience. That's like one of the first rules, right? So, if you're developing products for WordPress, your audience is probably going to be everywhere WordPress is. And WordPress nowadays is everywhere. Which means that I definitely recommend you trying to localize your products. No matter if they're premium and you have to localize them elsewhere, not in the interesting WordPress store, or if they're free and you submit them to a repo. Localization is kind of a very important part of the growth of a WordPress product. And a lot of other companies are already doing it. If you wondered how Facebook grew so fast because It opened its platform for translation for all of its community. They made something called a community translator that allowed people to translate from the front end. I don't know, have any of you translated Facebook? Of course you have. Me too. Yeah? It's not just you. No worry. So Facebook is doing it. Twitter is now localized in more than 70 languages too. Booking.com is an interesting example. Their localization is in part of why they're so successful globally, along with other things, of course. So WordPress is just one of the examples of software growing rapidly because they are localizing and generating communities of people that are product evangelists, because people get things very personal once they get involved in them. Once you contribute a string to WordPress, WordPress becomes yours. It's like something that you've given part of yourself to. And then you keep going, you keep doing it because you want to be a part of that whole huge thing. So to grow your product, localize and find out who are the people that can help you in different places, in different areas where your business might be more successful than others. And to get started, come say hi to the Polyglots team. That's 40,000 people from all over the world. If you need advice for localizing in any language, you can just ask through the Polyglot Slack channel, for example. And you can also come talk to me. I'd love to introduce you to the team and also get you started if you'd like to contribute. So this means one language is never enough in Klingon, which is one of the WordPress locales. And those of you who are proficient in Klingon know that Klingon doesn't have a word for thank you. So I'm just going to say it in English. Thank you.